In humility, we have to submit to the fact that we're not perfect like God. In our assessments of relationships, we often make mistakes. And when this occurs, God will lead us to reconsider this relationship if we're being sensitive to His leading. And He'll actually do this in both directions. Sometimes we'll come to believe that God does want us with this person, but then God will lead us to reconsider this. At other times, you may come to believe that God does not want you with someone, but here too, God could cause you to reconsider this. So here are three signs God often uses to let us know when He wants us to reassess a relationship. Number one, if something genuinely changes in the equation that you used to originally assess this relationship, this is a good sign God is leading you to reconsider this person. One reason we must be sensitive to the Holy Spirit showing us that we need to alter our former beliefs about a relationship is because things really do change as time progresses forward. People always change. None of us will be exactly the same as we were 5 years ago. Hopefully, we are improving and growing with the Lord, but one way or the other, change always occurs. This is why we need to be open to God changing our views about particular relationships. Perhaps at first you felt released by God to date someone, but then a few months into the relationship, God has shown you new things about this person which are big red flags. Now that you have new information that truly changes the equation, it would be wise to reconsider what you originally thought about this relationship. On the flip side, maybe your intuition about someone originally made you feel that you would not be a good match with this person. But then through friendship, you realize you have a lot more in common than you originally thought. You're connecting on a deeper level and your feelings just change. Here would be a good example of God leading you to reconsider this relationship with this person. This actually happened to Paul when it came to his views about Mark. In Acts 15, 37 through 40, Paul and Barnabas went their separate ways because Barnabas wanted to take Mark, but Paul didn't because on a previous journey, Mark left them. But later on, after Mark had done certain things to change Paul's opinion of him, Paul wrote to Timothy and said, "Get Mark and bring him with you, for he is very useful to me for ministry." The point is, variables change, and when they do, it's best to reassess things with the Lord. Number two, if you're presented with facts that prove your feelings about this person were just plain wrong at first, this is a good sign God is leading you to reconsider your relationship with this person. Not only do things change, sometimes we are just plain wrong about people. Sometimes the circumstances and variables don't change, but God will show us that our original assessment of the variables at hand were incorrect. For example, you could have been interested in someone, but then one of your friends told you this person was a player. Since you trust your friend, you then viewed this person you were interested in differently and started to avoid them. But perhaps through serving together at church and listening to what other people have to say about this person, you now realize this person is not a player, and you were wrong to take the advice of your one friend. On the other hand, maybe you got to know someone and felt like they were a very genuine person, but then you have a close friend who has firsthand knowledge about this person, and they warned you that this person is actually a player. But you ignore that person's advice and start dating this person that you're interested in. And over a course of time, God shows you facts that this person really is a player and you shouldn't be with them. Nothing really changed, just your assessment of this person had to be changed because you were presented with facts that contradict your feelings. So this would be a good sign that God is leading you to reconsider this relationship. Whenever this happens, we have to be humble enough to change our minds. We have to choose the facts over our feelings when there is a contradiction between the two. Pride will tempt us to always go with our original assessment of people, whether it was a positive or negative assessment of this person. In humility, however, we need to reconsider our relationship with people when God is making it clear that we were just wrong about this person at first. In Acts 20, 29 through 30, Paul said, "I know that after I leave, savage wolves will come in among you and will not spare the flock. even from your own number, men will arise and distort the truth in order to draw away disciples after them. So be on your guard. Paul basically warned them, hey, some people who you thought you could trust will actually be people you can't trust. Be on guard and be willing to change your view of people. We must have the same mindset. When it becomes clear, our original view about someone needs to be altered. And if you're enjoying this video and you want to help me spread this biblical message to other people who might really need to hear it, one of the best ways you can do that is by tapping the thumbs up button, which lets the algorithm know that this is a good video. And number three, if your life dramatically changed once you made a definitive decision about this person, this is a good sign God is telling you to reconsider your relationship with this person. Many times in life, things start going crazy based upon our decision to allow someone to have influence in our lives. If things are going crazy in your life, it's wise to ask yourself, when did all this start? Proverbs 22:24-25 states, "Make no friendship with a man given to anger, nor go with a wrathful man, lest you learn his ways and entangle yourself in a snare." If you find yourself entangled in a snare, it could be because you got tangled up with someone you thought was good for you, but in reality was not. If you can trace the start of when things started going bad in your life to when you linked up with this person, this can be a sign God is telling you to reconsider your relationship with this person. However, if your life dramatically improved once you started opening up to this person and got into a deeper relationship with this person, this too would be a good sign God is telling you to reconsider this relationship in an even more positive way than you originally did. As Proverbs 13:20 explains, "Whoever walks with the wise becomes wise, but the companion of fools will suffer harm." If you are suffering harm by being around this person, reconsider this person negatively. But if you are becoming wiser by being around this person, reconsider this person positively. What qualities does God want you to look for in your future spouse? I give you three biblical answers to that question in this video right here. I'm Mark from ApplyGodsWord.com. I really hope this was helpful to you. Until next time, God bless.